So hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and it is ArtCast 310 now. This is going to be the last day on Dracula, finally. Seemed like it took a while, but it actually didn't work like straight through, all my time concentrating on this piece. I had to jump around on a few other pieces. So, seemed to take a little bit longer. I'm working now on Dracula's, body here, and I'm going to put the moon in, and I'm going to put a little bit of kind of smoky effect, and then I'm going to probably call it done. So, I don't know if you guys notice or not, but things should look a little bit different. I'm using a different camera. And I'm not quite sure if I got the settings right on it. This is sort of like the trial run of it. But what I've seen so far, it's looking pretty good. The microphone is another thing I need to, wait and see what this video comes out like, because the mic sounded pretty good just when I was just pointing at my face, but I'm not sure how it's going to be with it pointing at the art now, and my face off to the side, talking. So, we'll just have to see how that works. I wasn't going to buy a new camera, but I've been having troubles with the battery on my other camera. Just runs out so quickly. So I bought two more batteries, and while I was on eBay, I was just kind of looking around at what was there and everything, and I ended up coming across a camera body for a T1i, which is similar to my other camera that I shoot the animation with, but that camera can't record video though. It's a what is it? XSI, I think. A Canon XSI. I think they call it a Rebel. I can't remember, but it's basically a DSLR. And I bought that one for the stop motion, and boy, it's a nice camera, but a nice camera in my world. I'm sure that, there's camera snobs out there that go, oh, that's a piece of junk. Anyway, I really like it. And, any kind of stuff I need to shoot, to make look good, just photo-wise, I use that camera. Like if I need to shoot bigger pieces for my website and, art and things like that, I always use it. But, I never could shoot video off it. And I see other people using them and getting, really nice, images, nice depth of field and all that kind of stuff. But that was just kind of, out of my, what I could do. And then, anyway, to wrap the story up, I saw they had just a body only for sale on eBay that just kind of sat there and wasn't selling, and I went ahead and made an offer to the guy and got it super cheap. Just thought, for that kind of money, it was just worth it to give it a try. And the other thing about it, the other reason I was kind of thinking that this might work better is because I also have an external battery, basically, where I can, put a dummy battery inside the camera and then run it to run it to just a normal plug. So I have power. I can just plug the camera into, an outlet. And I have that because of the stop motion. So because you know you need your camera on for such long periods with stop motion. And what else? That's about it. So like my battery problems are possibly over if this works, and yeah, we're just gonna have to kind of see. So I'm just gonna give it a test. I'm gonna finish this up, this piece up for you guys, and just see what it looks like. Somebody asked me in the comments, you know, like the last video or a couple videos back, they were talking about the girl's hair down here. Did you guys see that? Let me see if I can bring it down. It's right here. But they were saying, you know, like in the video I painted over it and it looked very light and all this, you know, very white, because I was using the white paint, and you know, like it's a lot more subtle than yellow now. How did I accomplish that, basically? And you know, I only paint for a while in video. I don't paint the whole piece, so why it changed was because I just kept working on it, you know. I worked on it with the color pencil, and I use different color pencils. I don't just, you know, use the white, I use yellow and all that kind of stuff. And I just, you know, render it out and take my time and do it that way. So that's the answer. There's no real trick to anything. It's just more rendering, you know. It's like I put the white on it and I didn't like how it looked, so I went over it with, you know, some yellows and rinsing, you know, that kind of thing. So sometimes, like in the comments, I have a hard time responding to like specific questions, because they're even though that one wasn't super detailed, but sometimes people ask like really in-depth questions that would take me like a long time to write out, and I never know if they're around, you know. They're around later for the video where I do answer them, but, you know, that's an easier way for me to do it. I noticed a couple people already signed up for the mailing list. I mentioned it in the last, stop motion video. I got another one of those out. I'm going to try to be more regular on them. But I just set up a mailing list for my YouTube videos, basically. And links, and I guess I could put it on the screen, or it'd be in the show notes. I heard a little bit of the sound. I know that this camera will kick off at about 10 minutes. So I have to keep an eye on it. The other thing about it is, you know, you use like a normal camera lens, and the focus is like really touchy, and it's actually very loud when it's trying to refocus. So you kind of got to shoot it on manual focus, or shoot a video on manual focus, or just do it manually, which is kind of a funny thing, because I, you know, like manual focus and me actually don't get along well, because I don't have like perfect eyesight. And so when I look through a viewfinder, things, when I can sharpen them up and make them look good for me, but then they're actually, you know, when the camera shoots what it shoots, it's actually out of focus. So I used to wear glasses, and I don't know, they're somewhere around here. I don't really wear them anymore. I'm not that blind, but I'm a little bit, so I was always worried, like, about, you know, having, like, the LASIK surgery or something like that, where it fixes your eyesight. But I didn't want to ever mess up, you know, because you don't know what makes your artwork, right? you don't really know. You think it's, like, practice and hard work and all that kind of stuff. That's your theory. But what if it is just some, you know, anomaly or something in your eyesight or something, or like just some weird, you know, screw up somewhere in your biology that makes it work, and you don't want to go and fix it, or at least I don't. Maybe that's just like me being like superstitious or something, but that's why I never did it. My dad has not great eyesight, and he was always like, no, you should get that surgery, you know, it's like modern time, you know, and all that. Should take advantage of, like, the time you live in, and I agree, but not with that, though. I don't want to mess up, like, my art in some way, you know, and, you know, I've wondered sometimes if it's, you know, because it is based on, like, what I see, what I look at, so I thought, well, maybe the fact that it's, you know, that when I look, you know, because I'm nearsighted, so it's like when I look far off, it's a little blurry. I can see, you know, most things close up. But I thought, well, maybe that's got something to do with, maybe I see things a little bit different than normal, and that, you know, allows me to draw them. I'm not sure. I gotta find a black colored pencil. So this is a good example of what I was talking about before. You know, I already did the whites, and I'm kind of going back with the blacks, putting those back in, and just kind of, you know, randomly putting detail and all that kind of stuff in. So I don't just work like one sort of direction. I go back and forth, and then, you know, I want some smoke and with the moon, or I want some smoke, and I'm going to do the moon and everything. And when I do that, I'm sure I'll spray my airbrush a little bit here and there to get the, smoke effects, and who knows, I'll probably even come back and work on at least this top figure of Dracula a little bit more, because I'm sure he's gonna get misted out a little bit. So I think I'm gonna actually just kind of wrap it up. I might just go ahead and shoot the rest of this piece just so I can kind of test the camera out a little bit more. But thanks for watching, you guys. I'm gonna do a print of this piece immediately, because this was a commission, so look for that in the next day or two. And yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow.